All right, so we understand that it's important to create apps that are smart about using a device's memory resources. So now let's discuss one way to do this by implementing an efficient memory strategy to display a long list of data, which many mobile apps will need to do. So this strategy is called view recycling, which means reusing views that are no longer visible on the screen anymore. And by the way, when I say view, I mean the whole layout for a single row. The layout for a single row is probably created by a view group, so something like a linear layout or a relative layout, which can contain multiple views. However, a view group is just a view itself. And you may hear us refer to the layout of a single row just as a view. Now, the Miwok language is really big. And one way to go about creating the app is we could create tens of thousands of list items and add them to a vertical linear layout. But if you have that many vocabulary words, it can become really slow to scroll through the entire list. And the device could crash because it can't hold all these list items in memory. Now remember, memory is a limited resource. And the Android system and other apps need some memory to keep running as well. Now there's a more efficient way to do this. Using the list view and array adapter, we can create just enough views, meaning list item rows, based on what we need to fill up the screen. This means if we scroll upwards, we no longer need to see the views at the bottom of the screen. So let's just focus on the list view and array adapter structure. Now furthermore, we can recycle views. This means if a view is no longer visible on screen, we can reuse it by changing the data. So changing out the data inside the view, such as the text in a text view, changing out the image in an image view, and we don't have to waste time creating the entire view from scratch again. Now we take these extra views and put them in a scrap pile that can be recycled and reused. And another term you may hear people refer to them by is scrap views. So we keep a scrap pile, which is a bunch of views that aren't currently being shown on the screen right now, available for reuse later. So recycling. So to get into more details of how recycling works, say for example, the user is scrolling the screen. Say they want to go to the top of the list to see the latest new tweets or newsfeed stories. Now the list view realizes it needs to create more list item rows quickly. So when the user scrolls, it seems like the list items were there just all along. Now instead of creating a new list item from scratch, it can just reuse it from the scrap pile, if they exist. So to summarize, we created more rows on demand by reusing views in the scrap pile. And then it just becomes a matter of changing the data inside the views so it shows the correct information for that list item. Now, the list view is also smart enough to know that the views that were at the bottom of the screen have been scrolled off the screen. And these views are no longer visible to the user, so they can just be added to the scrap pile. And as the user scrolls even further up the list, we can use that list item row that used to be at the bottom of the screen, now at the top of the screen. So the goal of all this is to create as few list items as possible, because it's expensive to inflate views from XML to Java objects. Now to prove to you that view recycling minimizes memory usage, I've prepared two versions of the app. One in the current state of the app that's using a vertical linear layout with one text view per list item, and a second version of the app using the list view and array adapter. So the memory monitor tool is included in Android Studio to help you look at the amount of resources that your app is using. So professional developers use this tool to help them identify ways that they can minimize resource usage on their app. The difference in memory usage between using a linear layout and list view and array adapter becomes more noticeable when the number of list items increases. So I'll be demoing these two examples so that each one displays a list of 1,000 words. Now here I am in Android Studio looking at the linear layout version of the app. And notice that in the numbers activity, it's displaying a list of 1,000 words. And here's what the app will look like when we run it on our device. So tapping into the numbers activity displays our long list of words. Now with our device connected to the computer, we can run the memory monitor to check the memory usage of this app. But before I can run it, I'll need to go up here to Tools, Android, and enable ADB integration. So ADB here stands for Android Debug Bridge, so the connection between our device and Android Studio. So once that's enabled, go down here to Android Monitor in the runtime window. Click it open, and I'm gonna pull it up, and then click here on the memory tab. So this screen will allow me to view the memory usage of my app over time. So I'm gonna go ahead and run the app on our device. All right, so with our device connected, we see the memory monitor running, And we can see the amount of allocated memory used to just display the list of categories. So I pulled up what the screen looks like on our device now. And let's see what happens to the emulator when I tap into the numbers activity. Wow, notice that jump right there. So it went from around 2 megabytes to about 14 megabytes. So is this increase, this jump in allocated memory, considered good, or is it not so good? Well, the best way to check is to run a different version of the code on the same device. So we're going to be running it on the same device because it has a controlled set of resources. Now to do that, I'm going to hop on over to a new version of the code that's using the list view and array adapter to display the same list of 1,000 words. Now here I am looking at the list view and array adapter version of the code, and it's also displaying that same list of 1,000 words. And now let's take a look at what it looks like when we run this code on our device. So the category screen looks the same, but when we tap into the numbers activity, notice that the list of 1,000 words appears but with dividers. And so we'll talk more about how and why this works later on. Now back in Android Studio, I'm going to launch the memory monitor the same way I did earlier. So down to Android Monitor here, pull it up, and then go to the memory tab. So notice that the memory monitor ran after my device was connected because ADB was enabled. And the amount of allocated memory stays constant when I'm on the category screen. Now notice what happens when I tap into the numbers activity. So notice that slight jump there. So the number went from about 12.71 to about 12.84. So that's barely 0.1 megabyte increase in memory, going from the category screen into the numbers activity. So this time, the amount of memory used to display the list of numbers was a lot smaller than when we used the linear layout version of the code. And since we're using a smaller amount of memory, this version of the code, using the list view and array adapter, will run more smoothly on lower end devices. Now let's take a look closer into the memory monitor here. So it's actually showing us two things. So the dark blue section is the allocated memory, which is the memory our device is using at any given time. And this light blue section here is the free memory. So that's the memory available on the device. While it may be tempting to use up all the free memory on your device to make your app look a little cooler, remember that your app isn't the only one installed on a user's device. And it's important to leave as much resources for other apps as you can. Now here are two screenshots from the memory monitor for our two versions of the app. So this left side here is the version 1 of the app using the linear layout. And the right-hand side here is version 2 of the app using list view and array adapter. Remember that the allocated memory is shown in the dark blue section, and the free memory is shown in the light blue section. Notice that in both cases, the jump to an allocated memory occurs when the user clicks on the numbers category to navigate to the list of numbers words. So let's zoom into the linear layout version of the app. And we see the jump occurs from about 11 megabytes to about 14 megabytes. So this is about a 3 megabyte usage of memory used to display that list of 1,000 words. Now compare this to when we use the list view and array adapter, and it's barely using 0.5 megabytes to display an entire list of 1,000 words. So after seeing these two examples, I'd like you to check out the links below to learn more about using the memory monitor tool and other ways that you can improve your app's performance.